Hi, I'm Harry Hamill.
And I'm Elaine Hamill.
And we own the Black Mountain Farmers Market and have been involved in local food for local people for the last 14 and a half years. Unfortunately, for the last 3.5 months, I've been having to focus on what is very much a topic for everyone, food safety. There's legislation in the House and the Senate that has gotten a lot of attention, and there's also been recalls and people getting sick and all sorts of other problems that have raised the fears of Americans about the quality of our food system. Well, it seems to me that all this emphasis on safe food, which is coming out of this bill and the Make Our Food Safe Foundation, misses the point. What we need is safe food, yes, but safe food is not enough. We also need healthy food, because healthy food is always safe food, whereas safe food, or what people call safe, frequently is not anything that you or I would really want to be eating. So it's that emphasis on healthy food that we are trying to make certain is included in the legislation that is with the Senate, going to be in front of the Senate on the floor shortly. And healthy food is food that first and foremost is grown in a scale where you know what's going on and you're connected with the earth and the food and the people who eat it and the people who grow it. It is not this food that is grown with huge amounts of inputs and huge amounts of land and this sort of thing. Here in the mountains of Western North Carolina, a fairly large farm is 10 acres. You go down in the Piedmont and that wouldn't be anything, but that having the food close to people is a real key part of it. Healthy food is sustainable food. And healthy food is food where you know who grew it and you know under what circumstances it was grown. As a result, Elaine and I have begun convening the Healthy Food Coalition. The Healthy Food Coalition is meant to address that need for healthy food so that it doesn't get lost in the legislation that we're looking at. The legislation is being built on top of a registration of food facilities. In essence, any place where food is packed, processed, or held. And that is really associated with bioterrorism. It doesn't have anything to do with food safety. So we're building a food safety system on a base that is not really appropriate. As a result, the registration system that is currently in place, we need to take a real close look at. And that's something that I've been doing a lot of lately. And that system is not designed for safety, it is designed for traceability. So that if something happens, we're able to find food that has been intentionally contaminated by people who are trying to hurt us. What we need then is a system that is oriented towards size appropriate things. One size does not fit all. Industrial agriculture that's doing millions and millions of pounds of things and mixing things together, that's a totally different form of regulation than what is needed for someone like Elaine and me who grow on less than an acre of land. There are involved processes for the big things that are needed, and they're very important. But as we've seen with some of the recent food outbreaks, that's not working well, and that's what we need to be emphasizing in this legislation. And there's nothing that directs the legislation to where the problems are. The well-known plaintiff's attorney, Bill Marler, who's been working with these cases ever since 1993, has been quoted as saying that he's never seen a case of an outbreak that was due to food that came from a local farmer's market. And so local farmers markets don't need the regulation that goes on a large corporation. As a result, the key provision of Senate Bill 510, the FDA Modernization Act, and of the previously passed House bill that I am concerned about is the requirement for a formal, complex, involved, laborious food safety plan. That plan is appropriate for those large enterprises, but it is not appropriate for us. Local agriculture is small, and it will be forced to stay small if it has the requirement of a food safety plan placed on every food facility. We need to register all the food facilities, but we don't need the food safety plan to apply to them. As a result, I'm asking people to call their senators and say that they want the Section 103 of the bill, which does apply these, to only apply to larger enterprises. The number that I proposed is $500,000 gross profit, which is done on an averaged basis over 3 years. So it's $500,000 a year, but it's over a 3-year period, because in agriculture, our income goes up and down based upon a lot of different things like problems with the weather. Where I was? It's important to remember that we can grow the healthiest food in the world, but if we cannot get it to those who are going to eat it, then it doesn't do us any good. So we have to be able to process and to distribute that food. As a result, this provision would allow us to develop the infrastructure that we need. Now, we also need individual Americans to care about their local food. And that's what our Healthy Food Coalition is about. This is not a group that's going to take positions on anything. Rather, it is an informal coalition that will have its own website, and the website will be the means for us to put information up so that you as an individual person would be able to access the website and learn about what is happening as far as the regulation and legislation is concerned. As a result, you would be able to learn about the various things like the FDA's guidance on tomatoes, on melons, on leafy greens, about the National Leafy Green Marketing Agreement. There are all these things that you can learn about, and that's what the website will be. We will have the website up no later than December the 1st, and it will be just as the name is, healthyfoodcoalition.org. In the meantime, and afterwards also, we have an email address, which is also healthyfoodcoalition@gmail.com. I look forward to hearing from people who are interested in learning more, and I will do my best to help you have the information that you need so that you can then act in your own best interest in these regulatory and legislative issues. Thank you.